Hi guys, this is Lindsay here from the Glasgow Football Tour, and this is Football Makes Glasgow. I'm here on the south side at Cathcart Cemetery, ready to be taken on a tour by the Friends of Cathcart. Let's go. Cathcart Cemetery is a cemetery in East Renfrewshire in the outskirts of southern Glasgow. So I may be a wee bit cheeky saying football makes Glasgow, but bear with me. The 43-acre site is a garden cemetery and was built by the Victorians to be enjoyed as parks and gardens. For the Victorians, death was not something that was hidden away, but something that was celebrated in finely carved gravestones in a prime location. These graves were built to last, and by God we should be glad of it. This is a treasure trove of footballing greats, and it's only right we share some of their stories. Joseph Taylor played for Queen's Park in Scotland and won the Scottish Cup with the Spiders in 1874, 75 and 76. He was held in such high regard that Queen's Park played a benefit match against Third Lanark on the 5th of January 1889, which attracted 7,000 spectators at Hampden and raised over £100. The club then added £50 to the fund for his family, an enormous sum which assured his son's future and meant they would never have to sell his medals. This little pocket of the cemetery is affectionately known as the Rangers Triangle, with Toffee Bob, William Craig and William Wilton resting close by. William Wilton was the first manager of Rangers Football Club, serving the club in that position from 1899 until his death in 1920. During his tenure, Rangers won 8 league championships and the 1903 Scottish Cup. Not just your simple newsagent, R.S. McCall scored 13 goals in 13 games for Scotland and has the distinction of being the only player to have scored a hat-trick against each of the other home nations. Born in Glasgow, George Putulo moved to Barcelona in Spain whilst working as a coal trader. He made his debut for Barcelona in September 1910 and scored 41 goals in 20 matches during the 1910-1911 season. He scored a total of 43 goals in 23 games for the club. Willie Mailey played in Celtic's first ever game on the 28th of May 1888. He was the first manager of Celtic Football Club and was appointed in 1897. And over a 43-year spell, he would lift 16 Scottish Championships and 14 Scottish Cups. Hugo, as he was affectionately known, was a founding member and the first captain of the oldest football club in Spain, Sevilla. He played in the club's first match against Huelva on the 8th of March 1890, which Sevilla won 2-0. This is considered the first official football match in Spain.